Tape 2. I just took a picture the first time. My bad. But it's September the 19th. It's Wednesday. Just put on a video last night, and so it's labeled for today. There's some fingerprints all over my camera, so a certain 6-year-old little brother of mine must have gotten a hold of it. But we're out here today, and oh wow, when you look in the sun, you can see it bad. I wonder if I come over here. Yeah, I'm going to have to clean that off. That's going to bother me. But I'll do what I'm doing out here real quick, because I don't think it'll be a problem. Anyways, that's that young blue bar up here for the first time, I think. Is it? No, it's not. Never mind. Take that back. I haven't seen any of the young birds, or the younger birds that I put in here come up here yet. There they are, all three right there. Anyways, got the... That one's just old and empty. There's still water in that one. I know some of you guys like to freak out when you see water jugs turned over. There's still water in there. And like I said, I've been watering in the mornings. But everyone's doing good. They've turned over one water jug over here. It actually makes it pretty easy to know when they're out. It's just before they run out. It's light enough they'll knock it over. But anyways, still looking pretty good in here. Still got a little bit of food. They've got water in here as well. Willie's going crazy. Oof, Willie looks kind of rough. Some of them are molting. I'll do like what I was doing yesterday where I showed you all the rollers. I'll show the do something like that with all the birds at some point. But I'm gonna wait till after they're done molting. They all look kind of rough right now. That'll probably be a good wintertime video when there's not as much going on. But, anyways, probably scraped down the perches today. The only thing about this is that the third baby I stuck down here got kicked out of the nest. I found it this morning, and it was pretty cold, and it was bleeding a little bit, too. So I'm going to show you all how to deal with that. It's not a good thing by any means, but it does provide the opportunity for me to do a video showing you what to do should something like that happen. Also, we got a fresh new baby hatched over here that no one has seen before. That is what a newborn baby pigeon looks like. It's about the size of my thumb, and I don't have very big thumbs. And always, when you're taking a baby or an egg in or out of that nest, always shield it with your hands, because she's going to bite me. And there's no discrimination. She'll bite the baby, too, while I'm pulling it out. Also, she crushed one of her eggs, like stepped on it and crushed it. That doesn't happen very often, but it does happen every now and then. I think it's been probably at least a year since the last time I had a pigeon actually step on its egg and crush it. So, just seemed like worth mentioning. Sad too, because it was a good egg. It would have hatched soon. But that does happen every now and then. Not too often. Anyways, that's all I want to do out here. I'm going to take this camera inside. I'm going to clean off the lens, and because there's fingerprints all over, and then I'll show you that baby and what to do. It's just fine now. I already did what I need to do with it. I was more concerned about doing it at the time than videoing it, of course, but I will show you what I did. Also, now you all have seen my new intro, which I put on the last video. It was a lot of work because I was using Movie Maker and I was doing it on my laptop, and the first three times it said the video files were corrupted, like halfway through making it, and I had to start over. Then the fourth time I did it on a different computer and was able to make it, and then I accidentally deleted it. And so then I made it a fifth time, and that is what you will see on the last video. Unfortunately, having done all that, I put it on YouTube and found out that I couldn't monetize the video because of that song. And the other song in the video too, but that's less big a deal because I was planning on using this intro for all my videos for a while. So I didn't realize, I just was thinking that I paid for the song, bought it off of Amazon, so figured it would be fine, didn't realize it wouldn't be. So now I know, but now I'm going to have to, I'll probably leave the intro the same and just overlap a different song. I saw that YouTube has this video library or audio library or whatever on there. So I'm going to go through there and see if I can find something I like. But I did like the way the song matched up with it, especially how it started out and then it picked up right as that pigeon, which was Henry, if y'all have been watching long enough to know who Henry was, that was Henry, started flying faster, and then all the other birds following him. And I don't know, I just like that song, but who knows, maybe I'll like whatever I find next even better. But hopefully y'all like that. You're welcome to give feedback. I felt like it might be a little bit long. Or I should say, I definitely felt like it was a little long, but I still liked it. I like being able to, I've just done so many different things, it's hard to decide what to stick in there. And it actually, the fourth time I did it, which was the first successful time before I accidentally deleted it, was a little bit longer. It was about two minutes. This one's like a minute 30 or a minute 40 or something. It's a little long, and so I don't know. I'll work on it again. I may shorten it down sometime in the near future. We'll see. Feedback would be appreciated, though. I feel like there was something else I was going to say or ask about. I don't remember what it was, but my video's not over yet, so maybe I'll remember. All right, so here's the baby, and there's one thing we're going to notice right away. Is that it is panting. I don't know if you could see that. Mouth open. So we're going to remove it from the heat. It just started doing that. So there's something you learned right there. But anyways, when I found this baby, it was really cold. Kind of stiff. I thought it was dead. Thankfully it was not. Fan it a little bit. But it'll be okay. But you don't really want it to get like this. So at the first sign that it's panting like this, just move it out of the heat. But it was also bleeding on its underside. Kind of rather it. Anyways, from one problem to the other, it's not too bad yet. Anyways, it was bleeding right here. What I did was I put flour on it. Anytime you've got a bird that's bleeding, their blood does not clot well. But putting flour on it will help cause the blood to coagulate or clot. So there's a little tip on what to do if any of your birds start bleeding. And as far as it being cold, I just stuck it under this heat lamp, but I stuck it way down here on the ground and not too close to it, and you want to heat it up very slowly. And of course I wound up overheating it a little bit, but it's already not panting as much anymore. See, its beak is closed. What you want to look for is a bird that's just kind of moving around a little bit, not panting like this. But it's doing a little bit better. And you don't want to try and feed it or anything until it's warm either. Now that it has become nice and warm, after I've let it cool back off because it got a little too warm, I will I'll feed it, and I'll show you how to do that. I've done it in another video, but I'll video me feeding it for the first time. I don't know how it'll go. It's still pretty young, so hopefully it will go just fine. But anyways, so pretty easy. If it's cold, heat it up slowly under a heat lamp or some other source of warmth. I suppose in a pinch, if you had to, you could even just put it up next to you underneath your shirt. But of course, if you got a heat lamp, it's a lot easier to stick it under a heat lamp. Plus, keeping it under your shirt is not a long-term solution. But then heat it up slowly. If it's bleeding like that, flour will cause the blood to clot. Cornstarch will also do the same thing. And then you can feed it after it's nice and warmed up. So we'll do that in just a few minutes. I'll turn the camera back on for that. I'm not sure what caused it to bleed. I assume that it had been pecked or bit or something, but it looked more like a puncture, just a little tiny pinhole. So I don't know, but it's taken care of now. So, but do be cautious. Even that one little pinprick of a hole there, it was bleeding pretty good out of it. So anyway, so right now while it's not panting, that's more what you want to look for. So I'm gonna put it back under the heat just a little bit, not much, just right there. Not even at the right angle. Heat lamp's going down to here-ish, so it'll be okay. Anyways, I'll turn it back on, probably 5 minutes or so, and show you how to feed it. Alright, we're back over here, and the baby has had time to cool off a little bit, and this is more what you want. See, it's moving around a little bit, especially if I mess with it. It's interactive, it's not lethargic, feels pretty warm to the touch, but it's not panting or squirming about a ton. See, it's trying to preen its feathers now. It doesn't really have feathers yet, so I'm not sure why it's doing that. But they do, and it's a good thing, so that's what you want to see. This is what we'll be feeding today. It's KT Exact Hand Feeding Formula, and it's been in the freezer. So I had it over here under the light trying to get it warmed up some. But anyways, now we will move to the bathroom, and I'll show you how to feed them. Alright, so I've got a few things here. Of course, I've got our baby right here. We're going to try and do this kind of quickly before it cools off. And I've got our KT Exact Hand Feeding Formula, which I just refill these containers. You can buy it in larger quantities than this, which is a tan-colored powder. And it comes with this little blue scoop. Then we've got a mug to mix it in, and I grabbed a fork to mix it with. And this is actually what we're going to put the food in to feed the baby. This is just a paper cup. Dixie cup works well too. In fact, it would be even better for this size, but I don't have any. So I'm just using this. This works well if you're feeding a lot, or big ones, or both, because it holds a lot more. So what we're going to do is take a knife, and we're just going to cut a little hole. Come over here so hopefully you can see this well. But I'm going to be looking at what I'm doing because this thing's pretty sharp. So we're just going to make a small incision. I recommend having a backup cup in case you mess this part up and cut too big a hole, but I'm feeling a little ambitious, so I didn't grab a second cup. Anyways, just going to cut a little slit like that, and then another one going up. I said this thing's really sharp. It is, but it's... I'm not using very much pressure because I... afraid I'd do that. That's why I recommend having a backup, because that's too much. I'm probably just going to try it though and see if I can use it. I use my pinky to kind of wedge, make it bigger, just like that. And just try and size it pretty appropriately for the bird. So anyways, I'm just going to push it back now. And that's a little big, but I think it'll still work. So we're going to let the water be heating up. We're going to get it nice and hot, as hot as it will go. Which takes a moment. I would recommend turning the water on before doing that stuff, but I wanted you to be able to hear me talking, so I That's why I waited. Getting pretty hot now. So, making sure the food is very warm is really important. It should be around 100 degrees or a little more. You know, you don't want it to be too hot because it'll burn them, but you definitely don't want it to be cold. So this is not as important with bigger babies, and after they get around 2.5-3 weeks, I don't bother doing this anymore. But right now, all I did was I put hot water into this mug to warm up the mug. That way the mug doesn't cool off the food when I start mixing it together in there. It's actually hotter now, so I'm going to leave it that. I also left the fork in there to warm the fork up. I'm going to turn it down a little so you can hear me, and so I'm not wasting water. So, dump that out. I don't know how much will leave this go around. Take a little scoop here, dump it in, and start mixing it in. Now you won't be able to see this part very well, but I'll show you after I have it mixed. Now this stuff does thicken up as you stir it. So if you think you got it right on the correct consistency on the right try, think again, because it's just going to thicken up on you in a few seconds. You're going to kind of want the consistency of pancake batter, maybe a little runnier. That's still a little too thick. Now I grabbed a fork instead of a spoon, so this is going to be hard to show you. But it's about right now. About the consistency of runny pancake batter. Nice and warm. So we're just going to pour that into our cup. Now you can see it. Try and show you a little bit of what the consistency is like. But I don't want to cool it off too much either. Now we're going to grab our baby. We're going to insert its beak into the hole and just move the cup a little bit. Just vibrate it, basically, is what you're doing. You all have seen on the channel before a pigeon feeding its babies. And I'll try and include a clip just after this so you can see what it looks like when their parents do it. But all you're trying to do is mimic that. I like to push their heads down a little bit with it and shake it just like that, kind of quiver it. Just a little bit. And it may not eat very much this time. It tastes different than what their pigeon milk they're used to eating would taste like. But we'll see. Try and get as much in there as we can. Now I can feel with my fingers that its crop is expanding a little bit. It is eating a little bit. Probably going to mostly wind up wasting food this go around. But that's alright. Though the stuff is expensive. So it's still eating a little bit, so I'm still going to let it keep going. The food's starting to cool off a little bit, though. I'm not going to give it much more. That should be good for now. So I like to rinse them off with just a little bit warmer than lukewarm water. You don't want it too cool. You don't want it too hot. Just something you kind of got to get a feel for. And I use this tissue that I had him sitting on from where I had flour on his cut earlier to wipe him off. And then I'm going to keep an eye on that because it may start trying to bleed again. In fact, I'm probably going to go ahead and put some more flour on it. But right now, I'm just going to go put it back in the heat. Now to clean up. You don't want to let anything get dried off. That's why I rinse it off. This stuff is like concrete after it dries. But it's also pretty easy to clean up while it's wet. Just a little bit of water. And
and you'll be good.
And we're done. Everything's cleaned up, but I would not recommend letting that stuff sit in your sink. Make sure you rinse it down, because it will be like concrete when it dries. Alright, now, because that cut is somewhat fresh, I'm gonna lay this paper towel down. Take a generous amount of flour. And we're just going to sit him right in it. And that should ensure that he's taken care of. And that's all there is to it. Or she. Now, when I picked him up, it did not look like it was starting to bleed again, but I'm going to leave him on that flower anyways, just to be safe. That's pretty much all there is to it. While he's been sitting and warming up and everything, I have been going through those sounds in the YouTube video audio library, and I did find one that I thought was kind of okay that I'm going to use for now, but I really didn't like any of them very much. They'll be nice to use for when I'm speeding stuff up and I'm just giving you something to listen to while I clean or do whatever, but not for my intro. I haven't found something I really like yet. I may see if I can't find something else somewhere else that isn't copyrighted or something. I don't know. I wish that I was able to use it since I paid for it, but oh well. I can use it, I just can't monetize my videos with it, so we'll see, and you guys can let me know what you think. You can also let me know if you have any suggestions for something you think would sound good with it. Maybe some of you have been through a lot more of those sounds on YouTube than I have. But anyways, thanks for watching, and take care. And be sure to subscribe for more of these videos.